गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, इन लास्ट वीडियो वी डिस्कस अबाउट द लेसन वर्क ब्रिंग सोलस बाय APJ अब्दुल कलाम एंड हैव सीन ब्रीफ इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट डॉक्टर APJ अब्दुल कलाम, पर्टिकुलर स्टोरी, दिस पर्टिकुलर एक्सट्रैक्ट. And this particular extract is totally expresses the author's views on the work culture specially. And according to Dr. Abdul Kalam, whenever we want to get any knowledge from the great person or from anything, we have to be so humble, and that examples we can find with his meeting with Werner von Braun, the famous German scientist. And today we are going to discuss the lesson. So on my return from France, after successfully testing the SLV-3 Apogee motor, Dr. Brahma Prakash informed me one day that Werner von Braun would be visiting Thamba. I was to pick him up in Madras. This is the incident that happens in the life of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. On my return from France, after successfully testing SLV-3 Apogee motor. Apogee, you know very well, Apogee is about the referring to the point in satellite's orbit where it is at its greatest distance from the Earth. That you know very well, the use of the SLV-3, the Apogee motor. And after successfully testing that SLV-3, when he returned from France, Dr. Brahma Prakash, his colleagues or he may be his director, informed him one day that Werner von Braun would be visiting Thumba. Thumba, you know very well, it is situated at near Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. So this is where the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam worked. Would be visiting Thumba. I was to pick him from the Madras. And Madras, you know, the capital of. From that place, the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam has to pick up Dr. Werner Braun. And that is the incident, and that whole incident describe their conversation with each other. Everybody working in rocketry knows of von Braun, who made the lethal V-2 missiles that devastated London in World War II. As far as the Werner Braun is concerned, who was he? He was the great scientist. Everybody working in rocketry. Rocketry means the science of rocket and missiles. Knows of von Braun, who made lethal means very disastrous. Means able to cause or causing death. Very disastrous missile, lethal V-2 missiles. He has originated and developed that missile V-2, and that was used in World War II. And devastated London, and with the help of that missiles, they destroyed the London in World War II. And who was that von Braun, the father of rocketry, the father of the science of missiles? And that man was to meet Abdul Kalam, and that was the great opportunity for Abdul Kalam to meet that particular person, the father of missile. In the final stage of the war, von Braun was captured by the Allied forces. You know, Allied forces in World War II, Allied forces were USA, Great Britain, then our India, China, Russia. These were at one part, and against them were the Axis forces, means Germany, Japan, Italy. They were Axis forces, and between them, between these three groups, that World War II was fought. And he was captured by the Allied forces. Allied forces means after World War II, he was captured by Allied forces. And as a tribute to his genius, because he was first man to produce that type of missile, though that one missile could destroy a whole city like London. And that was a great achievement at that time, and one type of miracle that has been created by that one Brown. And because of that, they didn't even punish the one Brown, because at that time he was serving in the government of Germany. But giving respect to his genius, Von Braun was given a top position in rocket program at NASA. But after that, he was appointed at NASA because he was he fought against them. But giving respect to his genius, his talent, he was not punished. But instead of that, he was given a top position in rocketry system, a rocketry program at NASA. You know very well where is NASA. The working for US Army, Von Braun produced a landmark Jupiter missile, which was the first IRBM with a 3000 km range. Thus, long form of IRBM is an intermediate range ballistic missile. Intermediate range ballistic missile. Then there is MRBM type missiles, which means the medium range ballistic missiles. And there are also ICBM, intercontinental ballistic missiles. But for convenience of the differentiation, it is totally based on the range. How much range that's captured and how much beyond that range they lead the explosive. On the basis of that range, it is decided whether that particular missiles belongs to IRBM or MRBM or ICBM. This is totally based on their range, how much range they can capture while leading the explosives. So that is based on their range. And he firstly, after joining the NASA, the landmark Jupiter missile was, and first IRBM, the Jupiter missile was the first IRBM with a 3000 km range. And that was the first missile, IRBM missile, he produced. The V-2 missile was by far the greatest single achievement in the history of rockets and missiles, which was produced and invented by the Von Braun. It was the culmination. Culmination means, you know very well, the end of something, we can say. After that, nothing can be achieved. Especially it comes after a long time. And after culmination point means after which nothing can be achieved. Such type of spellings are out there. But V-2 missile was very far greatest single achievement in the history of the rocket and missiles. It was the culmination of the effort of Von Braun and his team in YFR, Society for Space Flight in Germany. Then before he was captured by Allied forces, he was working for Germany. And in that period in Germany, he has developed that V-2 missile. And that was the great achievement at that time. At that time, he was working for Germany. In 1920, he produced that V-2 missile in 1920. What had begun as a civilian effort soon became an official army one, and Von Braun became a technical director of German missile laboratory at Kummersdorf. And he just started that his attempt to begin some civilian effort, but after developing that missiles, that became the official army. And Von Braun became the technical director of Germany as a missiles laboratory at Kummersdorf. द फर्स्ट V2 मिसाइल वॉज टेस्टेड अनसक्सेसफुली इन जून 1942. इट टॉपल्ड ओवर ऑन टू इट्स साइड एंड एक्सप्लोडेड. दैट वॉज फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट एंड इन दैट फर्स्ट अटेम्प्ट दैट V2 मिसाइल वॉज टेस्टेड अनसक्सेसफुल. बट आफ्टर दैट इट वॉज सक्सेसफुल. दैट वॉज द पीरियड इन 1942 दैट मिसाइल कुड नॉट डू वेल एंड दैट वॉज जस्ट फॉल साइड एंड वॉट एक्सप्लोड. बट आफ्टर दैट इट टॉपल ओवर ऑन इन साइड एंड एक्सप्लोड. बट आफ्टर ऑन 16 August 1942 इट बिकेम द फर्स्ट मिसाइल टू एक्सीड द स्पीड ऑफ द साउंड. दैट वॉज द ग्रेट अचीवमेंट दैट That V2 became the first missile to exceed the speed of sound, because it was faster than the speed of sound. We know the speed of light is so fast after the speed of sound, but after the faster than that, that the speed of that missile V2, we can get that information about that V2 missile. And that was exceed the speed of sound at that time, and it was successfully tested and in August 1942. That was, it is the little history of Von Braun, how he created V2 missile and how that missile devastated the whole London, and how firstly he was unsuccessful, but later on in August 1942 he was successful testing that missile, and that missile exceed the speed of sound. It is a little brief history about career of Von Braun. Initially he was working for the German Nazis, but after that, after having been captured by Allied forces, he was appointed at top position in the NASA laboratory at NASA. Then Abdul Kalam says, "It filled me with awe that I would be traveling with this man, a scientist, designer, production engineer, administrator, technology manager, all rolled into one. Such type of multi-dimensional character with him I was going to travel, and that was the feeling of awe that create the feeling of awe in the mind of Dr. F.J. Abdul Kalam. And that was really the feeling of excitement in the life of Dr. F.J. Kalam, such type, the father of missile, the father of rocketry system, an engineer, production engineer, designer, scientist, administrator, such multi-dimensional talented person was going to travel with Dr. F.J. Kalam. And it was the very great opportunity for Dr. A.P.J. Abdul Kalam to communicate with such person. The Avro aircraft I brought him in took around 90 minutes from Madras to Trivandrum. It's that Avro aircraft in which they were traveling from Madras to Trivandrum. It took near about 90 minutes, means 90 minutes means of an 1.5 hours. And through the flight, the Von Braun asked me about our work and listened as if he was just another student of rocketry. I never expected the father of modern rocketry to be so humble, receptive and encouraging. He made me feel comfortable right through the flight. And how did he feel in the US? I asked this if Von Braun, who had become the cult figure in America after creating the Saturn rocket in the Apollo mission, which put the first man on the moon, and such a great person, we know the first man, Neil Armstrong, who was first man, but that man was put on that moon with the help of rocket Apollo, and that Apollo was created by the Von Braun, and because of that, means he was became a cult figure. Cult figure means very famous in his department and in his field. In rocketry field, he has become the cult figure, means very famous figure. We can say the touchstone. We can say the very cult figure means famous figure. Anybody can give the reference of that particular man, that type of person he has become after creating that Saturn rocket in the Apollo mission, and which put the first man on the moon. And such a great person was traveling with Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, and he described his attitude. And he when they were traveling, and he just made him, and just when they were communicating with each other, he just asked me about our laboratory, our work, and he was just like the another student of rocketry. Means such a great person still behave like a student. Means getting to eager to get something new. Such type of person, very receptive. Anybody is telling there something, you have to be humble while listening. Such type of receptive person, such humble person can be so great. This is the lesson we can get from their conversation. Such a great person were so humble, so receptive, and just behave like he was just another student of the rocketry. And Miss Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam was in his own place, was a great person, but Von Braun was the father of in their field. But between the conversation between them was so friendly that Dr. ABJ Abdul never feels awkward while communicating with such the great persons. And student, if we want to get something new, get some new knowledge from anyone, we should be so humble, so receptive, and thus such lesson we can get from this particular incident, the traveling the communication in the traveling between the Dr. ABJ Abdul Kalam and Von Braun. The remaining portion we will discuss tomorrow. Thank you.